because most of these technologies are so fastly adopting, and if we are not introducing now, it is late. I cannot think of any field, as a matter of any field, where technology will not help them. Well, academics, what we do follow every day, don't allow us to fail. You're punished to be failed, correct? But STEAM, I see the other way.
Ms. Sunil, next question is a little tricky to ask you because as a parent and then as a branding professional, this is a chicken egg problem for you. I have come across the schools have challenged in terms of introducing a STEAM education like robotics in campus because parents cannot afford to have a fees or the fees is already published. We cannot ask more fees on this. As a parent, how do you see this challenge, or is there any way to look into this problem as a branding professional?
Yep. So yeah, this is exactly, you're asking a parent as well as a branding person. Yeah. So I have both sides of the coin. Yeah. As a parent, I would prefer that to be introduced at a early academic year. Okay. Mm-hmm. But as a branding person, I would say if there is a need for it, we should always find a way to get to it.
Right.
So if that value is advocated to the parents and if you are able to sell that. And because most of these technologies are so fastly adopting, and if we are not introducing now, it is late.
Right.
So we are not getting that 6 months or 8 months edge. Mm-hmm. It may be in between the year, but they get that 6 months edge and they are getting exposed to something which will be helpful for them going forward. Mm-hmm. And if that value is being absorbed by the parents, I think the parents would not mind shelling something extra if it is for the good of their kids.
Maybe a decade ago, or maybe a little more behind, that technology may not be in a forte for everybody.
Correct.
But now it has to be for everybody.
Yes, yeah. Totally agree.
Yeah. But there will also be an innovation in terms of educators thinking that the technology in hand can have two perceptions which they carry. One is the games, which can be very destructive ways of wasting time, not spending time. And then there's a lot of adult content which is available online. So. How do you see this chicken egg problem, and if you have to sell a technology to an education institute, how are you going to solve this issue?
Yeah, so I think technology nowadays is very powerful. So I would say with every power, there's a responsibility which comes along with it.
Right.
Correct.
Right, yeah.
So technology is an enabler and it's a very powerful tool. And as you clearly mentioned, like I cannot think of any field, as a matter of any field, where technology will not help them. So even you have seen like farming is adopting technology,
right,
correct?
Yeah, yeah.
So without technology, the things will not move forward.
Right, right.
But the second way of what you're seeing is like, there may be some adult content or there's gaming. So I would say that all these things needs some exposure, but it is the responsibility of the teachers, the parents and the society to help the children understand what is good, what is wrong. Correct? I make it very simple for my kids. I ask them a simple question. Whenever you're doing something, can I tell it to my parents? Can I share it with my friends? Can I share it with my teacher? Will they be proud of it? Or will they be, I'll be ashamed to do that?
Okay.
So that helps them decide whether it's a good thing or a bad thing. So the technology also, when the kid is using it, he needs to be well educated, or he should be very cautious. Okay, if I'm doing this, will my teacher appreciate it? Will my parents appreciate it? Or I need to face some questions, or I need to...
Yeah.
So it becomes very natural to them, and building that character at an early age helps them in the long run. Because this is the question, even when you become a professional or you become anything. So this comes up, like in our professional thing, ethics comes into picture, business code of conduct comes into picture. So what is correct, what is wrong? We should be able to make a call, because we would not be there with the kids every time. We would not be there for the employees every time. It should not impact your own brand. So you as a person have a brand, and it should not impact your brand.
Mm-hmm.
So as long as we can inculcate that into them, saying like what is correct, what is wrong, the technology will never be misused.
Individuals have a choice, but they also have a choice with at a risk, and it is not risking just themselves, it's risking many other people. And it is a responsibility equally of everyone who are in this ecosystem.
Correct.
I feel each individuals can be branding themselves. How do you think STEAM could help one in branding themselves?
Yeah, this is a very interesting and very personal to my life. The real academics, what we do follow every day, don't allow us to fail. You're punished to be failed. Correct. But STEAM, I see the other way. Fortunately, it is not part of the core academics, mm-hmm. where you are given a project, you have an end goal to achieve, and you allow the kid to try different things, fail multiple times, and achieve it. So every time he fails, he is rewarded with a knowledge. He is rewarded with something new learning. Correct. So mm-hmm. failures are actually rewarded in STEAM. Okay, this actually helps them to get away the fear of failure. You can see any big celebrity. As a matter of fact, real life, the people who have failed are the ones who have reached to the top. Mm-hmm. Most of the great people, celebrities, they were all rejected in the first goes. Multiple goes. Correct?
Right. Yeah,
We know KFC.
Right. Yeah.
Correct? So the founder of KFC, mm-hmm. he started this business at the age of 60 years, and he was rejected more than 100 times, mm-hmm. but still that persistence, mm-hmm. he was not afraid of that failure. He was very persistent, he was very sure what he wants to achieve, and he was very clear about his goal, and he only changed his way to reach to that. Mm-hmm. And that sort of mindset you can inculcate only with non-academic things like STEAM. So where it allows you to learn from the failures, take an alternate path, but still be focused at what you want to reach to. To add to this, I have a different perspective. Most of the time, we facilitate everything to our kids, correct? We give them the fish, correct? But STEM education actually teaches them how to fish, because the problem and the solutions vary every time. It's not constant. The problem changes, and the solution to that also changes as per the context and as per the circumstances. And if you teach them how to fish, they can handle it by themselves, because we would not be there every time for them. So this STEM education actually gives a perspective for them how to fish rather than how to take the fish, not to expect fish.
I think this is a very interesting perspective, that failing is rewarding, and failing is okay to grow.
Yes.
And makes you a better person than otherwise. Taking this as a very interesting perspective, I would like to thank you for your time and a valuable insight. I'm sure the branding is a part of STEAM, and I'm sure a lot of people who are viewing this are looking for ways to brand themselves.
Correct.
And feel proud about the workplace they work for. Thank you for your time, sir, and it was nice meeting you.
Thanks, Santosh. It was really nice meeting to you.